Hey guys, welcome to this Mometrix video over chromosomes. In our last video, we looked at macromolecules and we were able to see how our bodies are composed. Chromosomes are thread-like structures made up of dense DNA strands which contain genetic coding and instruction in a sequential composition of genes. Chromosomes store, replicate, transcribe, and transmit genetic data in our body's cells. Structure of a chromosome. A chromosome's shape and size will vary with the cell's cycle. When in interphase, the chromosomes are not tightly packed, so they are invisible to the human eye. During cell division, the chromatin begins to condense. By the end of prophase, we begin to see well-defined thread-like arrangements materialize called chromonemata. During metaphase and anaphase, the chromonemata start to completely form and compact together and begin configuring into structures of chromatids. This cycle of variation in size and shape of the chromosomes during a cell's cycle is referred to as chromosomal cycle. The formation of chromosomes is most clearly observed at metaphase and anaphase, and the reason is because that is when the chromosomes are the most compact or dense, which makes them easier to see. A normal chromosome will have these parts. A centromere, or primary constriction. A chromosome in metaphase will have two twin sister chromatids that are connected with one another at a specific point, and this point is called a centromere, also referred to as the primary constriction. You will also notice that it is the point where the two arms of the chromatids begin to narrow. In anaphase, the centromere separates the sister chromatids into two distinct anaphasic chromosomes. Consequently, an anaphase chromosome is really just a metaphase chromosome cut in half. The narrow structures extending from the centromere are referred to as arms. Therefore, a chromosome in metaphase will have four arms, while anaphase chromosomes will only have two arms. If a chromosome's two arms are equal, it is referred to as an isobrachial chromosome. And if the two arms are unequal in length, it is referred to as a heterobrachial chromosome. If a chromosome has arms that are not equal, then the shorter arm is classified as P, and the longer arm is classified as Q. Chromosomes are given four different names based upon the position of the centromere. One, telocentric. This means that the centromere is at the very end of the arm of the chromatid. However, you will not see this in humans. Two, acrocentric. Acrocentric refers to a chromosome with its centromere placed closer to the terminal of one end of the arm, resulting in chromosome arms of different sizes. 3. Submetacentric. Submetacentric refers to a chromosome whose centromere is located near the middle, but not directly, so that the arms are still unequal in length. A metacentric chromosome is a chromosome with a centromere that is located in the middle, with two seemingly equal chromosomal arms. The surface of a centromere bears a specialized multi-protein complex called kinetochore, to which spindle fibers, or microtubules, attach. The centromere of a metaphase chromosome contains two kinetochores facing in opposite direction. Secondary constrictions. Besides centromere, a chromosome may have one or more secondary constrictions. The part of a chromosome beyond secondary constriction is called a satellite, which remains attached to the main part of chromosomes by a thread of chromatin. The chromosomes having satellite is called sac chromosome. There are two types of secondary constrictions, nor and joint. They're always constant in their positions and often used as markers. The NOR, or nor, nuclear organizer region, are specialized to produce nucleolus and rRNA. The joints sometimes develop due to breaking and fusion of chromosome segments. A telomere is a short, repeated DNA sequence, complexed with proteins. They are synthesized separately and later add to the chromosomal tips. The telomeres help in various ways. One, they provide stability by preventing infusions of chromosomes. Two, they act as initiators of synapsis. Three, they help in the shortening of telomeres, causing senescence and aging. chromomeres. Sometimes along the entire length of interphase, chromosomes appear beaded due to accumulation of chromatin. These bead-like structures are called chromomeres. At metaphase, the chromomeres are tightly coiled and are no longer visible. Types of eukaryotic chromosomes. 1. A chromosomes. A chromosomes are the normal invariant set of chromosomes which are diagnostic of the species. B chromosomes are extra chromosomes, mostly heterochromatic, smaller than normal chromosomes, and exhibit slower replication. They don't take part in mitosis, segregate randomly, and don't affect phenotype, though may cause a decrease in vigor. These are not homologous with any of the normal chromosomes. They derive from autosomes, cause deleterious effects in animals and plants, and affect fertility when present in large amounts. Functions of chromosomes. Chromosomes contain hereditary information in the form of genes and act as a hereditary vehicle. They control division, growth, metabolism, and differentiation in a cell. The ploidy of chromosomes determines the expression of gametophyte or sporophyte generation. Sex chromosomes determine the sex of the individual. Crossover and aberrations of chromosomes introduce variation in population. Chromosomes transmit hereditary information from generation to generation. I hope that this video over chromosomes was helpful. Be sure to check out our next video over DNA and RNA. If you enjoyed this video, then give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for future videos. Good luck and see you guys next time.